Well, this is why I ran. Because of you and the reaction like that. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. So, just a few minutes ago, I called to congratulate Senator Warren on her reelection. Look. You know, hold on a second. Let me first say thank you to my incredible wife, Kathy Jo. You are the love of my life. Thank you so much. I want to thank my amazing two incredible daughters. They are just incredible. And so I want to thank my daughters, Kaylee and Emily, for being so supportive as well. And like I said, I called Senator Warren because after an election like this, I was very glad to have had the chance to debate her three times and talk about the issues. And I think we did. And I think that for 18 months, we talked about the issues on the campaign trail. And I think that with Senator Warren, I'm hoping that she will focus on those issues that are important, whether it's law enforcement, the fishing industry, and the other issues that we brought up. But we fought hard for the past 18 months. We left no stone unturned. Traveled to Pittsfield and Deerfield, Springfield, Worcester and Sutton, Lawrence, Lowell, Salem, Gloucester, Waltham, Attleboro, New Bedford, Fall River, Bourne. You guys know Bourne? And I know that I gave it my all, but I also know that you gave it your all too. There was a 19th century philosopher who said, if you learn from a loss, you actually haven't lost. So I really feel that's how this campaign went. With your support, we won every straw poll in the primary. We won the Republican convention by 30 points, and we won the primary itself by 29 points. Unfortunately, we came up short on this final goal, but I am proud of the honest and principled campaign that we ran. I'm also proud that you joined me on this journey, and I want to thank some special people who had the courage to believe in the underdog, so bear with me for a second. Larry Calderon and Mike Leary from the Boston Patrolmen's Association, thanks to them. Jeannie Carroll and Mike Perlin from Boston Police Superior Officers Federation, they also were supportive. Bobby Hall from the Everett Police Patrolmen's Local 94. John Mazey, who's here. Jimmy Gabriel from Everett Police Superior Officers Local 95. Rob Reedy from the Association of Marshfield Police. Hank Turgeon from New Bedford Police Union. Peter Kaur of the Taunton Patrol Union. Matt McCaffrey of Taunton Superior Officers Union. Greg Hayford and Mark Sirigano from Weymouth Police Superior Officers. Kevin Harrington from Whitman, right here in Whitman. Where are you, Kevin? There you are. The IBPO Local 509. Thanks, Kevin, and thanks everybody from Whitman Police. I appreciate that. Tom Daly of Worcester Police Patrolman's Local 911. Jay DeAngelis and Jason Thayer, who are here tonight from Norfolk Corrections Officers. Where are you guys? There you are. Tom Grinelli of Plymouth County Corrections Officers. Mike Talbot. And Todd Bramwell of Fraternal Order of Police, thanks to those gentlemen. Rick Pedrini, Jim Guido of Massachusetts Police Association, Harry McGilvery of Massachusetts Municipal Police Coalition, Paul Larkham and Tom Daly of New England Benevolent Police Association, John Nelson and Scott Hovespian of the Massachusetts Coalition of Police, Chris Coleman and John Parlone of ICE Local 207. All of those law enforcement officers, I really appreciate your support of me in this campaign because I certainly support the work you're doing, putting your lives on the line, the men and women who wear the blue, and corrections officers, ICE officers, the work you're doing to keep our communities safe. Thank you all, everybody I listed there for that. We also had a few folks that were courageous enough to cross the party lines, and that's Bob Correa, former mayor and state rep of Fall River. I want to thank him for his support. Dr. David Constantine, former Governor's Council of New Bedford, Larry Giordano, City Council of Methuen, Michael Marchese, the Alderman from Everett, Brett McCauley, Ward 22 Democratic Town Committee Chair in Boston, Paul Walsh, former Bristol County DA, Bob Hoey, a school committee member in Lowell, Democrat, and also Dan Freitas, Selectman in Fairhaven. Those men and women also very glad to have their support crossing the line and saying, this is not about party, this is about the people of Massachusetts. So I was very proud to have their support as well. A special thank you goes out to Denny Drury, who headed up Veterans for Deal, Lori Withrow, and Melissa Juarez, who spearheaded Women for Deal, Cam Kay, who is my chair for in Lowell for Cambodians for Deal, Kathy Carr, powerhouse of support. Thank you, Kathy, very much. Christy Smirlis and Elizabeth Crampton, also huge, huge supporters. Thank you for all the work, all the time. Of course, I want to thank our tireless campaign staff that's over there. Young men and women who've worked so hard. I know they've got an incredibly bright future, and I really look forward to seeing what they end up doing down the road. So while the outcome is not what we wanted, we've laid the foundation for taking Massachusetts back for the working people, I think. And I am a firm believer that when God shuts a door, he opens a window somewhere. So together, we're going to find that window. And thank you all to everybody here. I was so honored to be your nominee for the United States Senate. Thank you all very much.